are taking a look back at the best bits of the series.
That's right, we're checking out the coolest acts, the gungiest games, the biggest names, and the most lol-worthy laughs we've had on the show.
Because it's Friday.
It's 6 o'clock.
And it's the very special Crackerjack Awards. Get your voices ready, come on, let's see you shout. It's Crackerjack, 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 Crackerjack. Join in with us on telly, that's what it's all about. Oh, such a lovely word, it's Crackerjack, Crackerjack, Lumberjack, Steeplejack, Wumblejack, Crackerjack, yeah! Come on, are you ready? Don't let me catch you out. Crackerjack Awards,
where we'll be celebrating the finest moments with these, the highly respected and sought-after Golden Cabbages.
And what better way to start than to recognise all the top performances we've seen this series. Dancers, contortionists, magicians...
And, of course, my amazing mind-reading act.
Ah, yeah, sorry, mate, we had to cut that bit.
What? Why?
Boring.
My mind-reading app's boring. Fine, all right, then we'll do it now. All right, we'll see what's boring. Yeah, think of an animal, any animal.
Matt, we've not got time for this, so...
Do it!
All right, fine, I've got one.
Right, look into my eyes. Penguin.
No.
Dog.
No.
Duck.
No.
Has he got feathers?
Anyway, this Golden Cabbage goes to all the genuinely incredible acts that we've had on the show.
Chipmunk.
It was a cat.
I knew it!
He likes to come out just at the end. There we go. He's going to say bye to... Hey! Derek! Really?
Yes!
Do you want to introduce our full act for everyone? Okie dokie. One and all, prepare to be amazed as he juggles those balls. Yes, while standing on one leg. Yes, and I recite the alphabet. Okay, backwards. Yes. And I will levitate. What? Gonna levitate.
What, like float in midair?
Mm-hmm.
Right, okay, how are you gonna do that?
Just lift your arm. Drum roll, please. Z, Y, X, W, V, U, T, S, R, Q, P, O, N, M, L, K, J, take a breath, I, H, G, F, E, D, C, B, and A!
Here on Crackerjack, we take games very seriously, and this next award is for outstanding...
Ooh, hello!
What are you doing?
Ah, you know, just having a bit of a laugh with the long arms of the long arm of the draw. Hey, a lot of fun, aren't they?
Brilliant. That's ruined that then, isn't it?
Oh,
cheers, mate.
Oh, I see. Sponge your pants. They're great fun as well.
Yes, I know they're great fun. That's why I've put them on. I was planning to do a really funny joke about pants, but then you came in with your long arms and you ruined me gag.
Hey, don't be down, little buddy. Chin up. You can still do your joke, no problem.
Just leave it, will you? Get on with it. The Golden Cabbage for lengthy limbs and gungy bums goes to...
Sponge your pants.
And long arm of the draw. Hey.
The best of luck, Biker. Draw quick, Mwaxi, guess quick. Good luck, your time starts now.
Draw that.
Oh, here we go.
A star!
Yes! Draw that!
What is it?
A heart? A heart?
No.
A dog?
Yes!
Well done!
All right, draw that. Can you see it? Yeah. All right, what is that?
Ooh, is that a fish?
No, it's not a fish. It is an animal, though.
Ooh!
Oh! Using a lot of the board
there. Oh, jeez! What is that? Is that a dinosaur?
Guess any animals.
The one that's really fast.
No.
The fast one. A duck.
He can pass.
Pass.
It's an elephant! Come on!
Elephant! Of course
come
it's
on.
An elephant!
Be quicker!
Come on!
Of course this is an easy one. This is
come
an easy
on.
One.
Is this an easy one? He says
right.
That. Wait.
All right, come on.
It's a ball.
No. It's foodage.
It's foodage, tomato, oranges, banana.
Tomatoes on it.
Spaghetti bolognese?
No! Be better, Marty!
Bang!
It's pizza! Oh, it's one!
Fish?
Not a fish, not a fish.
Not a table.
It's some sort of animal, I'm going to give you that clue.
Dog?
Not a dog! Bigger than a dog!
Cat.
No, not a cat!
Cat's not bigger than a dog!
You're also
horse,
not a dog!
Horse!
Yes. Come on, quick!
A potato!
No!
Avocado!
No!
The nucleus!
No!
Said, I'm sorry, Lucia, he was right, he was absolutely rubbish.
You don't deserve to win, Marty. Sponge your pants! What L do you have two of and use to walk? Darren.
Legs,
correct, go for
10 seconds! Go!
Yes, good technique. Nice start.
All right,
come back. Any idea what that word is, Darren?
No,
no worries.
What C is an orange vegetable that rabbits eat?
Carrot.
It's correct, Freddie. 5 seconds, come on.
Yeah. Oh, he's got a good technique.
All right, come back, Freddie, come back. Have a look. Any idea?
Is it crazy?
It isn't.
It's game is, though.
What S is a reptile with no arms or legs?
Snake.
It's a snake. Go, you got 5 seconds.
History.
Yes, it's history! Oh, my goodness me!
Well, you know what? It's all about technique, isn't it? Look at that.
Oh, my goodness!
Poor old Isaac. Poor old Isaac. What S has 8 legs and eats flies?
Spider.
It's correct. Spider. OK, Freddy, come back, come back. What does it say?
Snacky.
It's not snacky.
I think Scarlett knows this.
I think she doesn't know it. Okay, get your hand on your buzzer. Okay, what bee has 2 wheels and pedals?
A bike.
Scarlett, it was Scarlett.
Bike.
It was bike, yeah. Go. Oh, there we go.
Okay, back,
she's
back,
got the clean sponges.
What did he say? You literally did all the work there, Freddy.
Thank you very much.
We all love a good laugh.
Oh, yeah.
And there is nothing that can make you laugh more than a good joke. For example, knock, knock.
What?
I'm doing a joke. Come on, knock, knock. You say who's there.
Oh, right, who's there?
No, I'll start again.
Yeah.
Knock, knock.
Mark.
What are you doing?
Well, you said who's there and it's me. I'm Mark, so not Mark. It's me.
Are you doing this on purpose? I say knock knock, you then say the words, who's there?
Oh, all right. There's no need to get all angry about it. Go on, go again. I've got it now. Come on.
Knock knock.
Who's there?
Doctor.
Oh, no, are you all right? Is that rash again?
No, Doctor Who. You say Doctor Who.
Doctor Who's here. Oh, wow. I love a bit of Doctor Who and her time-travelling capers. Has she brought a TARDIS with her?
Listen, I say knock knock, you say, who's there? I say, doctor. You say, Doctor Who. I say, you just said it. It's a great joke.
I don't get it.
Oh, just... The Golden Cabbage for biggest lols goes to the Crackerjack.
Oh, Doctor Who. I get it now.
So now, lesson number 3 of Gunge Foo. How to defend yourself against an assailant Horned with a big book in a gunch, or, as it's also known, a Scandinavian slime ambush.
Really, Sensei, you don't have to do this.
No! Please! Please! Look! How I... through the dojo! Like a young gazelle across the Serengeti. Swimming across the... Excellent. Because what we've learned there, right? What we've learned there is the most important lesson in Gunch Crew, which is never, never be afraid to get gunched.
Yep. You're suddenly showing us that, Sensei.
Yeah.
Oh, look at the time. Shall we call it a day?
Hey, whoa, whoa, whoa. Wait a minute. Yeah. No. It's not so easy now, is it? You're not going anywhere because now it's your turn. We're going to see... We're going to see how yous lot get on when I bring out the... in.
Why have you gathered us all here, Detective?
Ah! I am glad you have asked, Miss Dibas. Mon ami, as you know, we have recently suffered from a spate of robberies committed by the mysterious and also cheeky Batem thief. A thief so cunning that he steals using only his Batem.
I know. He stole my sandwich.
And my beloved pocket watch.
And my favourite trousers!
No, actually, they're hanging up over there.
Oh, my mistake.
Right, so that's a Peter Bleater margarita with sweeter paprika for the eager eater. The one and only Lawny Pepperoni with bologna, homemade macaroni. Oh, yes. And a foamy minestrone. The Hawaiian with fried dandelion and pork pie invented by a man called Orion O'Brien. The fromage of all with Roquefort, Roquefort, and a brie you can pour.
You don't have to say all of them, you know.
Yes, yes, I do. It's got a good Gouda, a better feta, the best red Leicester, and even better, a really redder cheddar that's a really good spreader, a Shropshire Blue that's more like glue, a Stilton 2, a Camembert that's turned to goo, and a Norwegian Blue with a particular hue. It's best before, mind you. And finally, the meaty treat feast with gammon, lamon, ham, spam, clam and Jamaican bacon with flakes of acorn and, unless I'm mistaken, a sirloin steak on. Not easy, that, you know.
Let's try treatment one.
OK.
Sam and Mark, you are going to stay approximately an arm's length apart from each other at all times. That way, Sam can't possibly smack you in the face.
OK, right, so...
Huh? Oh, yeah, look at that! Look at that! That's great!
Hey, works now!
Very, 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 very interesting. But there is another treatment we could try.
Huh? What is
Mark,
it?
Take those bandages over there.
Yeah.
Tie Sam's arms behind his back.
Oh, all right. I'm sorry, mate.
Hey, don't worry. It's all right.
All right. All right. Okay, yeah.
Now, Sam, you are going to try and smack Mark in the face.
Mark, you know I never do this on purpose.
Just do it, mate.
Okay.
Very, very, very interesting. You're cured.
Yes. Hey, Mark, high five.
Oh, yes. Oh, Doc, you fancy some lunch? Come on.
Gin is good.
Slime is sublime.
And mess is marvellous.
Which is why this golden cabbage is for our Gungis game.
And that is why, in this segment, I'm going to allow Mark to push this pie into my face.
Yes, that's right, and I can't wait.
Here's how it's going to work. I will announce the winner of the Golden Cabbage.
And then I will put this here pie right in Sam's face.
So, without further ado, I can reveal that the winner of the Golden Cabbage for the Gungiest Game is... Are you ready, Mark? I'm about to say the winner.
Yeah, yeah, I'm ready. Just get on with it.
Okay. I can reveal that the Golden Cabbage for the Gungiest Game is... Oh, wait a second. So are you going to pie me with your left hand then, not your right hand? Because it just affects which side I face the camera?
Yeah, it's my left hand. You just do what you need to do, announce the winner and I'll do the rest, all right? Yeah?
Okay.
All right.
The winner of the Golden Cabbage for the Gungiest Game is...
Oh,
does that cream smell off to you?
I don't know.
Splatterjack! This might be the Splatterjack moment.
You're going to get it! You're going to get it big time!
Wow! Ready, steady, go!
In your face,
ah! Hey, Charlie, you look in a right state. Here comes your next question. Oh, this is embarrassing.
Oh, what?
How many times have me and Mark been nominated for Best Presenters at the Children's BAFTA Awards?
Wow.
Embarrassing. I mean, who put this on here? I did.
Oh, we haven't seen the answers yet.
OK, right. We've got an answer from Eddie, if you'd like to reveal your answer. Once!
All right, over here, Ruby has put 7.
OK. I can reveal...
Ooh, interesting.
..that we've won it twice. But we have been nominated 7 times!
Ruby! Spot on! Good Summer Mark knowledge. Great. I'll talk in the third person, whatever. OK, Ruby! 3, 2, 1, get cranking! Go, 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 go! Stop, stop, ha!
How many hours and minutes long is the film Moana? Fantastic film.
It's one of the best.
OK, we've got an answer over here.
1 hour and 30 minutes.
OK. Liam is saying 1 hour, 30 minutes.
OK. All right, Amelia, you've gone for 1 hour and 3 minutes.
The answer...
Oh, man.
..is 1 hour... ..and 53 minutes!
Oh,
which means, Liam, you have won 3 seconds to crank up Jameel. Hold on, lad. Hold on.
I think he only needs 3.1
Jameel, seconds. How are you feeling?
Great.
This might be the Splatterjack moment. The best of luck, Liam. You've got 3 seconds. Your time starts now!
Go, 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 go!
Oh, my goodness!
Wow!
How are you feeling, Jameel? You nearly got me, mate. Look at this! Right, next question, guys. I'm going to put it out there. Eddie, if you get this one right, I reckon you'll be the winner. How many are in a baker's dozen? OK.
Eddie, if you would like to do yours first.
13. You're saying there's 13 in a baker's dozen.
And we've gone 12 over here.
I can reveal the answer is 13! Oh! Well done, Eddie. That means you've got it right. You've won 3 seconds worth of cranking, and I think this might be the moment. How are you feeling, Richie?
You're far too smart.
Waxy, how are you feeling?
I feel great.
Funny, that.
Right, well, let's see what happens. You've got 3 seconds, Eddie. Enjoy it. Ready, steady, go!
Go, 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 go! Come on, come on!
Right. Best of luck, Amelia. You need to get this one right to stay in the game. Here comes your question. In what year was the Christmas movie Nativity Rocks released?
Okay, we've got an answer. Amelia, what are you saying?
2000.
The year 2000.
Phoebe?
2018.
Naga, have you seen the Nativity Rocks?
Let's just put it this way. What does this face tell you?
Well, I can reveal that Nativity Rocks was released in 2018! Yes! Phoebe, I don't think you're going to need 3 seconds, but we're going to give you 3 seconds and your time starts now!
Here we go!
Merry Christmas, everyone! some top celebs on the show this year, and so to present the next award, Mark has booked, in his own words, a big star. So, oh, for goodness.
Hello, I'm a big star. My name is Capella. I shine brightly in the night sky. See how I twinkle.
Seriously? Seriously? Oh, you're such a peanut brain.
What?
Oh, how dare you talk about Capella like that. He didn't mean it, little one. You shine brightly like a young star.
I wasn't talking to the star. Just give me Costello, will
it's
you?
It's Capella.
Whatever.
No,
just
no, 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 no.
You animal. This Golden Cabbage Award goes to all the stars, the real stars, who have been so brilliant on the show.
Congratulations to you all.
Actually, to be fair, Capella's more professional than you.
What do you think the problem is?
Do you hear that, Doctor?
Yes. It sounds like he's eating something funny.
Oh, Doctor. Doctor, you've got to help me out!
OK, no problem. Which way did you come in? Right, I think it's time to knock him out, Doctor.
Yes, Doctor.
Arsenal! Oh, we need to operate quickly. This is not a drill.
But this is! Oh, that's strange. He's completely empty.
Why didn't he tell us he was empty?
I just didn't have the guts.
Right, I'm going back in.
What's he got? He's suffering from a little guitar. Crikey. Not just your job, that's intense.
Exactly.
Intense, everybody. Thank you. I'm going to
Oh! What's that?
Well, I had a light lunch.
It's a strong start. Let's hope that Nixon and Rhodes can maintain this level of quality as we move on to the next part of the show. Back to you, Jeff.
Sam, thanks.
Yeah, cheers, and Mark. But that's fine. That's fine.
That is absolutely fine.
This brief interlude is brought to you by Crackerjack Fizzy Pop. Just one slurp, and you will.
Hey! 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 Hey Golden Cabbage Award is for the best game featuring a bear, so I think we all know who the winner is.
Yeah, catch the bear.
What?
Yeah, catch the bear. Run around, try and catch the bear.
Whoa. No, try again.
Where's the bear?
What is that?
Yeah, the bear hides and everyone has to find him.
It's not even a game. Come on, you know this.
Bear hat. Everyone has to put a hat on the bear.
Come on. Bears. Truth.
Bear or truth?
Close. Swap it around.
Truth, bear or? Bear tennis.
No.
Penguin.
What?
Badger?
No!
Shark?
What are you doing?
Sorry, I got confused. I thought we were doing my animal guessing magic trick again.
Right, focus. Right. You can do this.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
The Golden Cabbage Award for the best game involving a bear and truth and lies and gunge is...
I've got it.
Watch it! Right, James, here comes our two facts. In 2004, an octopus with 12 legs was caught off the Dorset coast and nicknamed Leggy Freddy.
Interesting. This is my fact.
Food passes through a giant squid's brain on the way to its stomach. So, James, which fact do you think is the truth? Is it many leggy Freddy or is it squid brain tum tum?
I'm thinking that it's yours because there's like, I don't think it can go through your brain. But I am thinking, like, some humans are born with, like, two thumbs and stuff like that.
OK, so you're thinking it's possible that an octopus could have been found with 12 legs and named Leggy Freddy?
Yes.
In that case, stand in front of my door. We're about to ring the doorbell. Let's hope it's Joe or Harps. Get away, you cheeky bear! The most expensive bicycle in the world cost $63,000 and featured diamonds on the wheels.
If you may, here is the fact for my door.
The fastest speed ridden on a pedal bicycle was 183.9 miles per hour. So, Evie May, which fact do you think is the true fact? Is it mine, pricey bikey, or mine, really speedy? What are you thinking, Evie May? Which
yours.
One's the true fact?
Yours.
Mine? You think pricey bikey is the true fact? Why do you think that?
I don't know, I just think.
All right, in that case, if you'd like to stand in front of my door, let's see who's behind the door. Oh, you cheeky bear!
In the face! In the face!
Back.
The planet Uranus smells of eggy trumps.
Here's the fact for my door. At 70 miles per hour, it would be quicker to drive to the moon than to drive all the way around the Earth's equator. So which fact is the true fact? Is it mine? Brum brum moon zoom.
Or is it mine? Eggy pongy planet. What are you going for, Georgina?
Come to me.
Come to
stay
me.
Where you are. Stay where you are.
My fact.
Where are you going?
True. Where are you going? Are you staying? You are so not on that map right now.
You thinking your anus smells of eggy trumps? Final decision?
Don't.
Oh, no. Whoa.
Are you absolutely sure?
I think so.
Fingers crossed. This is the right one. Let's ring the doorbell. Georgina, a point goes to you.
27th of July is Take Your Houseplant for a Walk Day.
Oh, come on. Crab's ears are in their stomachs.
So, Henry, which fact is the truth? Is it mine, walky plant?
Or is it mine, crabby tum-tum? What are you going for, buddy?
Have you ever seen anyone take a houseplant for a walk? Particularly on the 27th of July.
Okay.
Interesting.
All right, are you confident?
Not really.
That's fair. All right, let's find out. Best of luck! Nice
glasses. Off you go. Go on, Henry, off you go.
So it was my fact that was true, Henry.
Really?
Yeah, 27th of July is Take Your House Plant for a Walk Day. Get it in your diaries, guys.
The official royal cat who resides at Buckingham Palace is called Mr. Socks.
The first ever passengers in a hot air balloon were a sheep, a duck, and a rooster. Which fact do you think is the truth, Lola? Is it mine, balloon animals,
or is it mine, Cattingham Palace?
I'm going for balloon animals because they sent up animals into space before they did humans.
In that case, if you'd like to stand in front of my door, Lola.
Okay.
Let's hope this is a point for you. Let's ring that doorbell.
Oh, come on!
Means after that game of truth or bear, it's 2 points each! We've got a tie-break situation on our hands, which means we need to ask you both a tie-break question. So if you'd like to please grab your boards and your pens and then step on your mats, please.
The nearest one to the correct answer will go through to play double or drop.
While the other, I'm afraid we'll get one last sliming from the very naughty bear. Let's bring him out.
Oh, the naughty bear's coming!
Oh, is he? Oh, get away!
No, Lola's already running off. Stay on your mat, Lola.
Here comes the question.
Sam and Mark...
That's us.
...have a combined age of what?
Take a look at us. Look at our beautiful, youthful skin.
Yeah, got a lot of makeup on.
Take my age. Take Mark's age, add it together. What do you get? Right, James, have you got an answer?
Yes.
Okay, what have you gone for? 70.
And Lola's gone for 40. Oh, Lola, I love you so much. Can reveal that I am 39, Sam is 34. So the correct answer is 73, which means James is closest. Oh, you're the winner, guys! Mr. Bear! Lola, you're in big, big trouble. Turn round and get what's coming to you.
Go on, Bear, go on, Bear, do it.
As you've seen, we've had some hilarious comedy sketches on the show.
But sometimes we just don't have enough time to squeeze all the brilliantly funny sketches into a show, which is why this next Golden Cabbage goes to the best unseen comedy sketch.
I think I could be in line for this award.
What do you mean?
Well, I've got an unseen sketch and I think it's pretty impressive. What do you think?
What is that meant to be?
It's a sketch of Leonard.
Leonard?
You know Leonard, who works in the shoe shop. Eh?
Mark. That sketch is absolutely fantastic! It's the best thing I've ever seen in the whole wide world!
Do you really think so?
I think it's brilliant, mate! It looks just like Leonard!
Thanks, mate!
No worries, hey, Leonard! Come and look at this, what Mark's done! It's uncanny! Looks just like you, mate! But right now, let's check out the Golden Cabbage Award-winning Best Unseen Sketch.
Second best sketch.
Truth.
Wave, Leonard.
We were getting one of those fancy smart speaker thingies. This just looks like a cheap knockoff.
Annabelle, I don't know what the problem is. Look, this is voice activated, does exactly what you say, and it was half the price.
There we are.
Oh, look, watch this. Right, now, Maxine, hello, my name is Rob.
Hello, Bob.
All right. Maxine, no, we are Rob and Annabelle.
You are Bob and Abel.
All right. Look, maybe I need to speak a little clearer. Right. Maxine, play some music.
Spraying some mucus.
Oh, you are such a mumbler. Let me try. Maxine, play some music.
Playing bum music.
What?
Bum music, some music.
Darling, you have to say her name.
Maxine, just turn it off.
Turning it up.
Maxine, no more trumps.
More trumps.
No, Maxine, just stop the music.
Just slop the mucus.
vaccine.
Stop, please, now!
Now, slot cheese.
What? Vaccine, doctor!
Sorry, Bob, I don't understand.
Vaccine, I order you to stop that now!
Ordering you a top hat cow.
Special delivery.
Moo.
Don't ask me, you ordered it!
I think I know why she was half dressed, darling!
There's only one thing to do, darling, a fast!
Ah, alone at last. Activate party mode. Ordering pizza.
If you ever in a jam, here I am. If you ever need a mate, I won't wait. If you ever feel so happy you land in jail, I'm your bail. It's friendship, friendship, just the perfect blend ship. When all the friendships have been forgot, ours will still be hot. La la la, dig dig dig.
Woo!
If you're ever down a well, ring my bell. If you ever lose your shirt, I'd be hurt.
Aww.
If you ever lose your teeth when you're out to dine, borrow mine. It's friendship, friendship, just the perfect blend ship. When all the friendships have ceased to gel, ours will still be swell. La la la, dim, dim, dim.
Cabbage is our special award for services to cabbages.
And to present this highly sought-after accolade, we have a very special guest, and it's someone I had to pull a lot of strings to get here. Please welcome the Cabbage Keeper.
Hi, Cabbage Keeper. Thank you so much for being here today. Would you like to say a few small words before presenting this very important golden cabbage?
Really?
Cabbage Keeper, everyone.
Grace, poise and dignity. I'm truly humbled.
Cabbage of very few words, but such an inspiration.
I love that cabbage so much.
Oh, hey, I guess we better do this bit then.
Yes, true, yes.
The golden cabbage for services to cabbages goes to...
Ooh.
Double or drop. It's that time again. It's like right on edge.
Tough question.
What animal is grey and has a long trunk? Big prizes.
We're starting with one top of the range. Mop! And cabbages.
Show the cabbages! Give the cabbages!
Seriously, you all right? It's time for double or drop! Good luck, Amy. Here comes your next question. Harry Potter has two best friends, Ron Weasley and who?
Hermione.
Yes! Yeah!
Yes! Well done!
What is the name of the snowman in Frozen?
Olaf.
Correct! That is incredible.
I mean, the seat's right on edge. It's like right on edge.
Which planet is closest to the sun?
Mars.
No!
Mercury!
Unlucky! What famous Justin Fletcher character on CBeebies carries a spotty bag?
Mister!
Yeah, humble!
The irony is not lost on me! Come on.
What do you hit over the net in badminton?
Bats!
No!
We're moving into a maths round.
Oh, James is happy about that. Molly, are you happy about that?
No.
No, Hannah, you happy about that?
Kind of.
Cabbage Man, are you happy about the maths questions?
Yeah!
How many zeros are there in 1,000?
Three.
Correct! Yes, Molly! Oh, the strawberry just got off my head.
What is it?
You've got some cards of some...
different types of it.
I think we're going to have to get the prize.
Yeah, bad at this.
How do you say goodbye in French?
We're saying...
Sam, how are you when it comes to maths questions?
I don't like it.
Forget you've got cabbage lives remaining. The best of luck. Here comes your next question. What is half of 66?
33.
Great time!
Tremendously well. We're moving on to round five.
Five.
Okay. What is the name of the fairy in Peter Pan?
Tinkerbell. I'll give us a thumbs up, mate. Yay!
Great times.
Indeed. And the winner of the Golden Cabbage for Best Presenter goes to... The Cabbage Keeper?
What?
Oh, well, he's great.
You know what? Actually, well deserved, if you ask me.
You can't compete with the Cabbage Keeper.
Very true. But I'll tell you something, Mark. Yeah. If he hadn't won it, that award would have been in the bag for me.
Well, I might have won it as well.
No way! That award was mine!
Hang on a minute. I was in with a chance.
Oh, come on! You would have never have beaten me.
Look, let's just do this last bit. It's nearly the end of the show.
Fine. Oh, what a great series we've had. I've loved every minute.
Me too. And we'll be back with a brand new series soon.
So we'll see you then on Crackerjack! You really think you'd have won Best Presenter over me?
Well, why not?
I'll tell you why not. I'll tell you.
Wait, go on.
Because
yeah.
You, no. Not a good no. presenter.
You're not good at this.
No, look at you with your silly faces. Oh, no, my God, you do it, mate. Tell me what I'm doing. You talk all the time.
I'll tell you!
Tell me!
When your voice is ready, come on, let's see the shout. It's Crackerjack!
We are going to be having more fun than a brazen crustacean.
Chasing Jason with a carnation.
In front of the nation. It's Joe! How are you doing, Joe?
Hello, very
How is this different to your usual gig at presenting BBC Breakfast?
Where do I start?
Oh, yes!
The ladies love it when I go, ooh la la!
My bum look bigger.
Chris, I'm not gonna lie.
I'm going to Ganji!
We never ever give away our Crackerjack pencils to our guests.
Oh.
And we're not gonna do it today either.
Oh. Something to tell the kids at school. Oh, such a lovely word is Crackerjack.